Okay, we'll continue. So we'll continue with holding in Yud Beis in the middle. About we're discussing Amram, realized that the decree of Pharaoh that all boys should be thrown into the Nile, didn't want to have a deal with such a situation, so he divorced his wife. So now, since he's the leader of the generation, so everyone now divorced their children. His daughter said to him, "Father, Abba, your decree is worse than power. Power only decreed on the boys, if a boy is born. And you also decreed by divorcing the mother, your chevet, you decreed also on the girls, because if you continue married, you might have a girl. Now that you are not married, you rule that out." So, Paola Goza, another thing she told him, Paola Goza al Belomaza. I believe she was 6 years old. She made this argument with her father, the Gedoil Hador, the leader of the generation. So, Paola Goza al Belomaza. By the way, there's a Gemara that says that Amram was one of the tzaddikim that was passed away only because of the sin of the snake. He had no sin on his own, because of the original, the primordial sin. But he himself was a complete tzaddik. So it says, "Power goes out of the world, zeva to the world, zeva to the world. You have decreed on this world and the world to come. Power only wanted to take away this world." Power, Rosh HaSofik Miskemes, Yosofik Miskemes. The wicked power, maybe his decree will be fulfilled, and maybe not. Ato Tzadik, so you are a righteous man. Vadashik Zosofik Miskemes, so your decree will for sure endure. So it's not a, so therefore, your decree is for sure will be observed. So it's Shenema Vatikze Oimer. So you would utter a decree and it would be done. The pasuk in Iyov, "Madorchecho noga il." So Omad v'Yichzir Sishur, so he right away married his wife. Omdu Kulam remarried his wife. V'Yichzir and Shusem, so everyone now remarried their wife. Some say that it's because of his greatness that he, Amram, heard. He kept an open mind, even though it was from a six-year-old girl. She told him something that made sense, and he said, "You know what? I made a mistake." Remarried his wife. He saw it. Everyone remarried their wives. Everyone saw that Amram is got married, so they all remarried. Vayikach v'yachzor mibale. It says vayikach. It should have said v'yachzor. It should have said he remarried. Why does it say that he just took a wife? Amar vida v'azvinu she'osu ma'aseh likuchi. So he didn't just remarry her like a small wedding, 10 people, just to get it out of the way. He really made a marriage, a shiva v'apirya, and he made a whole wedding. We're dancing, and the serving angels said, the mother of the children are a glad mother, children, haleluka. As Bas Levi, you are the daughter of Levi. Efsha Bas Meir Ushleish Pshona Ava Vekola Bas. Is it possible she's 130 years old and you're calling her a daughter? She's Ama Vechama Chanina Zu Yechevet Shorosa Baderech. Yechevet, her mother, conceived her when she was on the way to Mitzrayim. Veledoso ben Achimus. She was conceived in Eretz Yisrael, and her birth was at the entrance to Mitzrayim. Ben Achimus. She ne'emar she'olda Yisrael Levi, says that she gave birth to Levi in Mitzrayim. Was born a Levi in Mitzrayim. Veledoso ben Mitzrayim ben Eros in Mitzrayim. Her birth was in Mitzrayim, but she was not conceived. The conception was not done in Mitzrayim. Amar Rabbi Yehuda Shenolda B'Siman in Nawus. Another thing, why it says Vayikach instead of Vayachzer, that he married her instead of remarried, because she suddenly became young, Simon and Naus. Because at her advanced age, the physical characteristics of a young woman were reborn in her. Taro Yishova Teilet Bein, so she got pregnant and she gave birth to a son. Now, she was already pregnant with Moshe 3 months before, as we will shortly demonstrate. That the Torah mentions here that Yocheved conceived, so that we may compare her act of giving birth to her act of conceiving. Just as she conceived without pain, so too she gave birth without pain. From here we see, it may derive that righteous women of all generations were not affected by Eve's verdict, that womankind would have to suffer pain in childbirth. There's a whole list over here of the 70 descendants that went to Egypt from each of the 12 tribes, each one with their sons. And most of them didn't come with grandchildren. It looks like only Yehuda had Chetzon and Chamul, and Osher had Hever Malkiel, Dan had Chushim, which it is child, not grandchild, and most of them didn't have. Most of them came to Mitzrayim being fathers, not grandfathers, except Yaakov, obviously. She saw that it was good when she gave birth to
Moshe.
She gave birth to Moshe, so it was good. What does it mean it was good? Tanya, Tov Shmoy. It says, Tuvia, Tov Shmoy, that his name was Tuvia. That's the first name given to Moshe by his mother, by his biological mother. His name was Tuvia. That's why they said, it has that she saw that he was good. Rabbi Nechemiah says, no, not disagree with Rabbi Meir. He says, what is Toiv? Hogun and views that he fit for prophecy. She saw that this child fits for prophecy. Rabbi said, when Moshe was born, the entire house was filled with light. It says here.
You're off.
She saw that he was good. God saw that the light was good. She hid him for 3 months. The Egyptians began counting only from the moment that Amram married Yocheved. So the whole divorce really tricked them. She had been pregnant with Moshe for 3 months before. She could not hide him any longer. Let her continue to hide him. Whenever the Egyptians heard that a baby was born, what did they do? They would bring an Egyptian baby there, so that they would hear each other and cry together. And these babies, who were the cause of Jewish tragedy, are alluded to in scripture, which is the Song of Songs. Dichtiv Echzu Lonu Shu'olim, Shu'olim Ketani V'Gemel. God said to the sea, grab for us foxes, the small foxes who spoiled the vineyards when our vineyards had just begun to blossom. What does it mean, a weaker basket? Why weaker? It says, why not something strong? From here we see, it comes to tzaddikim. The money is more precious to them than their body. Why is it so, money is so precious to them? Because they never steal. Because their hands never touch stolen money. So whatever they have is theirs honestly and therefore precious to them. Shimon Nachmani said, she took a soft material, something that can handle something that is soft like a baby, but also something that is strong, they can handle being in the water for a while. She smeared it with clay and tar. The clay was on the inside and the tar was on the outside. Why? So the Moshe Rabbeinu, the tzaddik, should not be exposed to a bad smell, foul odor of the tar. She placed the child into it and placed it in the suf. Rabbi says she placed it in the Red Sea, the Sea of Reeds. Rabbi Shmuel Nachmani said, Agam. She placed them in the marsh. It's written, the reeds and the thin willows, suf, will wither. The daughter of power goes to, went down to wash herself by the river. Comes to teach us that she went down to the river in order to wash herself from the father's idols. She went to immerse herself in the river as an act of conversion to monotheism. When my Lord will have cleansed the filth of the daughters of Tzion, the maidens went with her. The walking is none other than expression of drawing closer to death. The maidens were about to do something for which they would deserve death. Similarly, it says, look, I'm going to die. Once they saw, the maiden saw that Pharaoh's daughter wished to rescue Moshe, they protested. And they said to her, Gvirteinu, our lady, the norm in the world, the flesh and blood king issues a decree. If the entire world does not observe it, at least his son and daughters will observe it. Yet you are violating the decree of your own father. The angel Gabriel came and then struck the maidens to the ground, disposing of them. She, Pharaoh's daughter, sent forth her amo and fetched the basket. One said it was her hand, one said it was her maidens, that her hand was extended. How can you say it was her maiden if Gabriel just said that he struck the maidens, if it just said that Gabriel, the angel, struck the maidens to the ground? So who remained for Pau's daughter to send? The Shah al-Khadus, it says he left her with one maiden. The Lav Ochad of Azmakam make him lechud, because it's not proper for the princess to walk alone. Why doesn't it say Yodo? Hakamashman, the Ishtabu Ishtabu, so her hand was extended. We find with regard to the arm of Pau's daughter, we find it also with the wicked. It says the teeth of the wicked you broke. Don't say you broke, rather say you were extended. The whole story with Oig, that his teeth were extended and prevented him from throwing the mountain over the Jews. Vatiftach vatiru yisayelet vatiru mi baile. It says that she looked at the child. What is vatiru? Should have said vatiru. Why did it say vatiru? Rabbi Yochanan, Rabbi Yosi, v'chanina, shiros ha-shechina. She saw Shechina is with him. She saw the divine presence together with the child. Now, suddenly she sees a youth was crying. Is it a youth or a child? Who is it? Tano, yelled, the koilokin now. So is it a youth or a baby? It says, although it's a baby, but his voice was like a youth, like a now. That's the word of Rabbi Yehuda. You're making Moshe someone that possesses a defect, that he speaks like a youth when he is a baby. Moshe's mother fashioned for him in the basket a canopy of youth, symbolic of chuppah. Because she said, was concerned, maybe I won't see his chuppah. So she created some kind of a canopy in the basket. And the Batya, the maiden, the daughter of Pharaoh, the princess, she took pity on Moshe. But tell me, Alda Ibrim, she recognized that Moshe was a Hebrew boy. How did she know me? Nay Oda Omra, Rabbi Yisrael Avichana Shiroiso Mohul. She said, Mi Alda Ibrim Zeh, she recognized it's an Hebrew child, it's a Jewish child, because she saw that it was circumcised. I was Zeh. The words, this one teaches that she prophesied unconsciously. This one has fallen into the river, but no other baby will again have to fall into the river. She implied, without thinking, that the decree that male infants must be thrown into the river would be abolished that day. That is precisely what happened, because the astrologers no longer foresaw a threat after Moshe was outside of the river. Once he was thrown into the Nile, they saw that's it, it's over, he's dead. And they didn't realize that he was saved by one of their own. And so they felt like there's no more threat, so the decree was annulled. If people say to you, inquire of
necromancers
and diviners, ametzasim mehagim, who chirp and vocalize, tzifim venadim, tzifim, they envision future events but do not know what they envision, mehagim and mehagim, they vocalize but do not know what they vocalize, they have a vague idea of what they are divining, but not a well-defined picture. They saw, the astrologers saw, that the savior of the Jewish people would be stricken by water. So that's why they came up with the decree that every son that will be born into the river shall you throw him. Once Moshe was casted into the river, in the basket, we no longer see something like that. Assuming that the potential savior must have already drowned. But the Egyptian abolished their decrees, but they do not realize that it would be Moshe would be stricken in connection with the waters of strife. Later on, they are the waters of strife that the children of Israel contended with Hashem. They are the waters that Pharaoh's astrologers saw and erred. 600,000 men on my account are the people in whose midst I am. Moshe said to the Jewish people, "Bishvili nitzalkol kulchem." It is because of me that you were all saved from being cast into the Nile. My descent into the river ended their decree. The day the Moshe was cast into the Nile was the 21 day of Nisan. So they were 26, so 4 days ago. 5 days ago. Amu malach ha-shozif na-kadosh baruch hu. The same date on which the splitting of the Red Sea would take place 8 years later. 80 years later. Amu malach ha-shozif na-kadosh baruch hu. Ribono shel olam, the angel said to God, the person who's going to sing on the as Yoshua sing the song of the sea will be smitten by this river. It was the sixth day of Sivan, the day of the giving of the Torah. And the angels then said different argument. Whoever, the one who is supposed to receive the Torah from Mount Sinai will be on this day, will be stricken on this day. The one who said it happened on the sixth day of Sivan, it is possible that there were 3 months between Moshe's birth and the day he was placed in the river. As Torah says, it says Moshe died on the seventh of Adar. She was born on the seventh of Adar. Shiva Adar v'Shiva Sivan, and from the seventh of Adar, when he was born, until the sixth of Sivan, when he was placed in the river, it's exactly 3 months. According to the one who said that he was placed into the Nile on the 21st of Nisan, how is it possible that 3 months passed from the seventh of Adar when Moshe was born? So the Gemara explains, so this year was a leap year, and thus had an extra month of Adar, and Moshe was born in the first Adar. So thus we have Rubo Shel Rishon, most of the first month of Adar, from Zayin Adar till beginning of second Adar. The Rubo Shel Achron, most of the last month of Nisan, that makes it full 2 months. V'emtzoi Sholem, the entire month in between second of Adar. Because 21 of Nisan and 7th of Adar. So that's a full, you got the full month of Adar, almost. And then another full month of Adar. And then 21 days from Nisan. So when Batya, the princess, the daughter of Pharaoh, took Moshe out, he was crying, so she needed to feed him. How can she feed him? She's calling a nursing woman. So the nursing woman, Moshe Rabbeinu, didn't want to nurse from them because they were not Jewish. He's not drinking Cholav Akum. So Miriam came forward and told her, I can bring a Jewish woman. Teaches that she circulated Moshe among all the Egyptian women who were nearby. Velo Yonak. Omar HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he did not nurse. Hashem said, the mouth that is distant to speak with the divine presence, should it nurse the breast milk of a woman who ate a non-kosher item? With whom shall one teach knowledge? To whom shall one teach knowledge? And to whom shall one explain a passage? To those weaned from milk, and to those removed from the breast. Pasuk means, to whom did God teach the Torah? To Moshe, who weaned himself away from non-kosher milk, and separated himself from its non-kosher source. The daughter of Pharaoh said to Miriam, go ahead, bring someone. She walked quickly. This word Alma teaches that she went with alacrity, like an energetic young girl. Miriam is called an Alma because she concealed her facts. She did not mention that she was the infant's sister and she was summoning his mother. Daughters of Batya, the daughter of Pau, tells Yocheved, Heilichi, this boy, which means nurse him for me. Paro's daughter was prophesizing, but again, unaware of what she was prophesizing, because she said, Heilichi, Heilichi can also mean, this is yours. Which obviously was Yocheved's son. And I'll pay you, I'll give you your pay. It's not sufficient for the righteous that they have, that what they have lost should be returned to them. They will also be given the reward for their troubles. I think Yocheved was the only Jewish mother, that only mother in the world that got paid for nursing her own child. Got paid.
Right. She had to take it. She had to cover herself.
Yeah. What they going on about is Aaron, Miriam, the prophetess, sister of Aaron, took her drum in her hand. Why does it say the sister of Aaron? What about she's not a sister of Moshe? What does it say a sister of Aaron? This teaches that Miriam prophesied while she was still only the sister of Aaron before Moshe was born. She was already a prophet. And she, her prophecy was, Asido imi shetelet ben, my mother is about to give birth to a child, Shemashiach, his soul, will be the redeemer of the Jewish people. When Moshe was born, the house was filled of light. Her father comes, Amram comes and kisses her. My daughter, your prophecy has been fulfilled. Once Moshe was thrown into the Nile, was cast into the Nile, her father tapped on her head, says, my daughter, where is your prophecy? And this is the meaning. My sister stood from afar to see what's going to happen to him. What does it mean she wanted to see what's going to happen? My so what's going to happen with her prophecy? What would be the end of her prophecy? Bukhim Tiyu should learn, God willing, continue tonight. 8 o'clock.
We got the Shulchan Aruch now.